Today we'll have Prashant Ruia with us, the director of Essar Capital. Prashant, thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you for having me.
Of late, there has been a general sense of gloom and doom in the Indian economy. And the government, over the last few weeks, has made several interventions. What is your take on the Indian economy?
So I think, firstly, the recent interventions which the FM has made, which Nirmala ji has made over the last 1 month, I would say, in a series of steps which the government has taken. Obviously, these are all hugely positive, and that has been reflected in the market sentiment. Having said that, we are facing two parts of a problem. For the first time, India is facing a drop in its consumption.
And
over the last few years, we have seen a significant slowdown in capital investment.
Yes.
And I would say these are the two things which we also need to address, in addition to addressing the sentiment and, of course, improving the investment climate. On the first issue, obviously, many of the industries which have faced problems, slowdown over the last few years, policy decisions would need to be made to address the issues in those sectors to get them back on a growth path. As far as the second issue goes, which is in terms of the capital investment, that is something where we have to bring back confidence in the Indian economy and for entrepreneurs or for businesses or for companies to start reinvesting.
What is that one thing or two things maybe which are still looking very bright on the Indian horizon?
So clearly, if you look at what's happened over the last few years, government and the policies which have been changed and many of the regulatory uncertainties which were there in the past have been addressed by policy changes which will ensure that new investments coming in will not face or will not suffer the same kind of consequences or the same risks which some of the older investments had.
Yes.
And that is a much stronger and a much safer regulatory environment for people to actually invest money.
Yes.
So that's a big change for the positive. And the second is that the consumption and the demand in India and the population of India and the demographics of India is not changing.
Yes.
So it's still very much the same. We are going to see growth. We are going to see growth in consumption. We are going to see growth in demand. And that growth has to be met. So if you look at the two, if you look at these two things together, it still provides for a strong investment rationale to reinvest and to grow and invest in the country. About 3-4 years ago, we took a call. We saw that the environment was changing very fast. And probably we didn't see a slowdown in growth to this extent. But we saw that, that the regulatory environment was getting difficult. We saw that there would be the banking system is getting fairly conservative in their lending. And they were getting affected, obviously, with the NPAs and losses. So we saw that the environment is getting difficult, and some of the impacts which were made on the regulation and by the courts would not get overturned or changed. And so we took a call that we would sell some of our investments which were doing very well, and delever the group or repay the banks and reduce our debt, and that's what we did. So the last 3 years, I would say, ahead of what most people saw, I think we were the first to get off the block and actually take some decisive steps with the exit of Essar Oil to Rosneft and Trafigura, with the exit of our BPO business of Aegis. So we did a few exits and used those proceeds and repaid about 1,40,000 crores of debt. And that, I would say that it's something which we did at the right time, because in in the current environment to do the same thing would have been much more difficult. Having said that, it's also it, to us it was a testament that the quality of the assets which were built, and the technology which was utilized, and the way these projects were conceived, were clearly right, because they attracted the best value, even though we were facing a difficult market.
So
that was a very good positive thing, which came out of this exercise.
Yeah.
But at the end of the day, that exercise is largely complete now.
Yes.
And the last 10 or 15%, which is largely pertaining to the power sector, we are doing now in the next 1 to 2 quarters. What has actually happened over the last few years, in terms of the FDI, we have attracted as a group FDI of over $32 billion.
Yep.
It started with the telecom,
yes.
when we sold to Vodafone, and then Essar Oil, and then Aegis, and then some other companies. But if you add them all up, it's nearly $32, $33 billion of FDI which has come into the country.
Yep.
And it's also a testament of the value which these investors see in these sectors and in these companies you know, going forward.
Now, what are your future plans in terms of expansion, new areas, maybe new ways of doing businesses? And what are the specific sectors that you're looking at?
Yeah. So I would say it in two parts, Ashu. One, while we have delevered and while we have sold some of our businesses, we still have a fairly substantial portfolio of assets and companies, right?
Yeah.
So in all, we are currently in the four sectors which we have, we're currently doing turnover of about $12 to $13 billion, and we certainly see significant potential value in these sectors. So whether it is the oil and gas business, where we have a refinery or refining in the UK, where we have a 16% market share in the UK, again a company which has got a lot of potential. We've now entered the retail market in the UK, and we're growing that by building a national footprint of retail outlets in the UK, or in the E&P exploration and production business, where we are trying to align our production of unconventional gas to the gas economy in India, which we see as a huge potential, not only because it's more environmentally friendly, but also because it is much more cost competitive compared to, you know, diesel or petrol or the fuel or the liquid economy for energy.
Yeah.
We are the largest in this space with coal bed methane and shale gas, and we see this as a huge potential. And then if you look at the power sector, power sector still is very much core sector.
Yeah.
A lot of people are thinking that we can manage without power. I don't think that's going to happen. We've seen a slowdown in the growth of the power. But still, if you look at project next 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, this is still going to be a very, very crucial part of our economy and will certainly come back, especially with all the steps which the government is taking now to get this sector going again. And then we are also in infrastructure. We are India's second largest port company. Our port capacity in India is currently, if I'm not wrong, about 13 or 14% of China. And so there's a huge potential,
huge gap.
And India has got one of a vast coastline, and a huge potential to become to provide, you know, port services. And we currently have about 110 million tons of capacity, but can grow manifold in this sector. And then on the technologies, in the technology space, recently AGC, our company made an acquisition in the US. Where we acquired a company called Black Box, which provides system integration services in the US. So, and then we've got a few other technology investments. So if you look at this portfolio and all, we still think that there's a lot of growth and a lot of potential coming out of these, out of our existing companies. Having said that, we are obviously going to look at growth in new sectors. Those will be the, I would say, more unregulated sectors, which are much more akin to the new economy, and which the market perceives differently or more valuable
yes.
from some of the traditional core sectors. So that's where the where our future investment is also going to come once we start investing again in the next few months.